Hey, what's going on, y'all? We back out here, Atlanta, Georgia, C Room. About to walk in here, kill this stage right quick. We're hoping for a good turnout tonight. Hoping to do our thing and give props to everybody that hit the stage tonight. But we're looking for this thing and move on to the next round. I was sitting at home like, ain't nobody gonna stop this.
Not being able to actually go over my material again, because like I said, I like to stay fresh as possible leading up to the event, and just driving, just having to make that drive was tough.
With that type of adversity hit you, do you think that you recovered well from it, or you think that it affected your performance a bit?
I think it affected my performance because, like I said, I was physically tired and just not mentally fresh. I could have dealt with the physical drain because, I'm on stage for 5 minutes and I perform, that's fine.
Yeah.
But if, if I'm not there mentally, then it's hard to make it happen. Going through my head as I'm sitting on that speaker is a few things. I should just change the whole set and go with something a lot more comfortable, because just after doing my research and looking at everybody else that was in the competition, I felt like my material would be strong enough to advance based on the competition. And so I started to do that, but I said, no, let me stick with what I have, and let me just master that, or let me just do well in this, because I believe in the new material that I have also. But I still had I can't even say it was a creeping doubt. It was like with me. It was beside me. It was on me that, dude, you're tired. You don't know this set like that. And you need to take care of this, but you're out of time. Yeah.
What's up?
I'm up next. And I said, third for me. I think that's the guy that went before me. He won it. Man, he had a lot of energy. I was like, man, if I could have some of that energy, well, I'll be all right. I'll kill it. I just didn't have it. And so I just took a deep breath and I said, because I'm still hoping for energy. And I said, if he plays me a good song, well, I'll be ready. Then he dropped whatever that was he dropped, and I was like, oh, this is not my day. It's not coming from anywhere but from me. Thinking a lot, and I felt that the people, even though it was just a few of them, it was a small number, I felt like they could see that I was thinking, and I stumbled like that first 10, 15 seconds, and then it was just it was awkward.
I hope it ain't me, because I don't see it long enough, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, I can go to jail, you know what I'm saying? Because if they come look for me, I know I've been cheating long enough, I need to be in jail until the weekend or something, you know what I'm saying? But there's a lot of awkward stuff going on, man.
When I got to probably maybe not my best joke, one of my favorites, fan favorite, I recovered, but still, lack of energy, just, I'm gonna keep saying it, I just didn't have that enthusiasm, it wasn't there.
I see you got some cougars in the house right now, that make it awkward for me. Cougars come up to you, Marcus. I'm not wearing any panties, Marcus. Sister Bishop, you need to go ahead and sit down somewhere. Real, man, it's awkward out here dating too, man. It's awkward for me because I keep running into all of these hood chicks, man. Not like, y'all know, man, I'm talking about not real hood chicks, I'm talking about these ratchet hood chicks. Y'all know what I'm talking about? The type of girls that get excited when you give them a bag of hot Cheetos. They be like, oh my God, these hot Cheetos is busted. Oh my goodness. Can't stand them ratchet hood chicks, man. I tried to take this one girl out, you know, take out to eat. So we go to the restaurant, and the waitress was like, all right, can we start you off with something to drink? Hood chick was like, let me get a water with a light ice, a bowl of lemons, and some sugar packets. I said, I know she ain't about to make lemonade, man. I know they about to go down like that. So the waitress leaves, she come back, she gives this girl her ingredients. The whole time I'm sitting there like, man, you know what? It's my fault because I knew better. I should have listened to my grandma when she told me not to date no white women. I knew. She told me to leave no white girls alone, man. But I love my grandma, man. My grandma, she's passed on now, but man, when my grandma was getting older, you know, I had to move in with her. And that was awkward for a few reasons, man, because like when my grandma was getting older, the doctors kept saying, hey, Kenny, she's getting older. She's starting to lose her memory a little bit. Well, I didn't know what they was talking about because she never could get that $25 out of her. For real. And not only that, you see, like, when I moved, I was young, you know what I'm saying, and I'm still trying to date, but I found out something. I found out that there's an age that people reach where they just don't care about what other people feel no more. And whatever that age is, that's when I moved in with my grandma. I brought this young girl home, you know, to introduce her to my grandma. I said, hey, Keisha, this is my grandma right here. My grandma was like, what's your name, baby? Keisha? Okay, let me tell you something, Keisha. You ain't pretty as a lad, boy. I said, Keisha, don't worry about it. She's just ready to see Jesus. That's all it is. Don't need worry about it, Keisha. Man. And then on top of that, like, well, another thing that made it awkward, like, I'm sitting there with my grandma, you know, I'm trying to have a normal conversation with her. All she want to talk about is who done died. I'm trying to tell her about my day. She want to tell me about who died this weekend. So I'm like, you know Frida died this week. She still owe me some money. They gonna pay her on Thursday. I'm gonna get my money before she gonna put it in the ground. I'm scared, y'all. I'm scared I'm gonna get to heaven. I'm gonna get ready to dap Jesus up. And my grandma gonna pop up. She's like, hold on, Lord. Kenny, you got the money you owe me? No, Lord, don't let him in. Send him down, Lord. Send him down. I think my grandma thought I was gay, too. For real. She kept dropping little hints when she was walking through the house. She'd say, it would be nice to have some great grandbabies around here. But I guess you need a woman around here for that. All I see is little boys around me. Say, Kenny, baby. Two ends ain't gonna cut the electricity on. Hello. Y'all, thank you guys for the great. My name is Kennedy Alexander Robertson. Contestant number four, Kennedy. Contestant number four, y'all. Y'all make some noise over my. The winner, by far, among the judges' vote, votes and the audience votes, coming in first place of the Atlanta round for the search for the one stand-up comedy talent. Search number one, Elton Walker!
my performance, you know, all in all, it was awful. It sucked. It was, and the reason I say that is because I know, you know, where I can perform, and I just underperformed. Like, I wasn't even average. It was just unsatisfactory. It was not a good performance. There's gonna be times where, you know, you're gonna be fatigued, you know, tired physically, but there comes a point where you're so mentally sharp that the fatigue doesn't bother you. You can still go out there and perform at a high level and do the things that you need to do, regardless of your lack of energy, because you'll have that enthusiasm even when your body, and then you'll find the energy, you know, your body will catch up because your mind is so sharp. And I just, you know, I didn't have that mental sharpness. And so what I'll do going forward is, or what I am doing, is just being more prepared, you know, going over my set, you know, 2-4 times a day, hitting up open mics every chance I get, recording my set, you know, audio, video, just seeing myself just do it more.